Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do the daily vibes for around the, 18th? Is it the 18th? You know the timing is fluid, right? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. So, remember that every word that comes out of my mouth is part of this reading. What do we have for a message today? It doesn't matter. You may want to pick your battles. Is it worth fighting over? Can it be easily fixed? Page of Cups. So this is good news. This is good news. This is welcome news arriving. Okay. Could be a very emotional day. In a good way, it doesn't admit, either way, okay, this could be emotional, okay, you know, there could be somebody that is even, maybe there's somebody that is younger than you that is coming with a message. This person looks a little weary, a little unsure, you know. Somebody looks a little unsure, and I'm not sure if they're younger or you're younger. There may be a little bit of an age difference, maybe just a little bit, not a lot. Now, this could be, it feels like there's opportunities for love here with the Page of Cups. Messages of love or good news, welcome news, unexpected news. But whoever is giving the news seems to be a little unsure. Six of Cups. Well, you may have some memories with this person. You may know this. You do know this person already. This is somebody that you already know. Maybe you grew up with this person. Somebody from your hometown. Somebody that you worked with. Somebody that you have some sort of memories with. Could be even a family member. Six of Cups, this is nostalgia, memories of love. There's love here, and love can be in many different forms. Okay, love is love, but, you know, there's different kinds of love. There could even be some emotional support. Whatever is going on, it does have to do with emotions. It has to do with the heart, expressing feelings, a little reluctantly by the looks of things. There's definitely an opportunity for love here. No doubt about it. I mean, there is, but these two cards, all right? Now, this six is the journey to balance and harmony. It is. It's the taking that road. So there is an opportunity for balance and harmony in a situation. Somebody may be wanting to do so and expressing their feelings. This could also be reawakening feelings of love. And it doesn't have to be somebody that you dated in the past. You may be communicating with somebody. It could be even somebody new that makes you feel like love again. That makes you remember what love feels like. These are loving messages, put it that way. And this is about remembrance. So it may, you know, it may reawaken your memories of love, whatever. Or somebody may be making memories. Could be somebody from the past, though, with that Six of Cups, because the Six of Cups does represent the past. Maybe there's going to be some sort of reunion, an upcoming reunion of some sort. It doesn't have to be a lover. It could be a family member. It could be a friend. It could whatever. Seven of Cups. My goodness, we got a lot of cups here. A lot of emotions. I knew that it was going to be emotional. A lot of emotions. There's some element of confusion here. Somebody has multiple options. They have multiple choices. needing to follow their heart by the looks of things, because heart is all over in this reading. This is all about heart. It's all about heart. I feel like we have at least one individual that has been contemplating, has really, really, really been contemplating, you know, what is the best option? What does their heart want? And they've been looking for love by the looks of things and really thinking about love, because cups are love. Somebody has probably made some poor choices, and there's consequences. And there is consequences with that Seven of Cups. There's consequences for the choices. So I think we have, and that's why this person is unsure. So we do have somebody that is unsure because, you know, they may be fearful of rejection or fearful of making the wrong choice. Somebody's in the process of choosing, you know, what is the best option? What's the best option for me? And thinking about somebody that they know, somebody that they may want to reunite with, or somebody from their hometown, or somebody that they grew up with, whatever, however it resonates with you, is part of the equation, is one of the options. Somebody is really, really, this guy, he's discontent, guy or gal, this person is really, really thinking about it, you can tell. I do believe that there is a message that is coming from this person, and it looks like they're looking at, they're taking an opportunity, because it's here, it's in this person's hand, and it's in this hand too. Somebody is going to be taking an opportunity that they may have been confused about, you know, they might have been weary about, because they had so many other, you know, choices, so many other options. Do they want love? They want fortune? They want fame? You know, do they want to focus on their job? Do they want to focus on this, that, whatever? So somebody was really confused as to what was going to be, you know, when you make a choice... Say if you make a choice to get married, just for example, that's top of the list, right? So it's a big, huge choice. It's a choice. It's a huge one. So, you know, there's so many options. Is this really what I want? Is because, you know, I don't know. That's what I'm seeing here. Knight of Wands reversed. Now, the Knight of Wands reversed is... Let me get one more, because I can go so many ways. That's not going to happen. That was a pile. I don't do that. Sometimes I do, but not always. Ooh, Four of Wands reversed. Commitment. Fear of commitment. This is fear. I was going to say fear, but it could also be reckless behavior. This is commitment. And it's funny that I brought up marriage. Because this is about, somebody may be fearful of commitment, you know, they may have been in some sort of confusion because they don't, you know, they don't want to get committed, they don't want to marry, they don't want to get married. Now this is the party is over though, this is the party is over, the honeymoon is over, nothing to celebrate, not happy, somebody's not happy, that's not happy. They're not happy. They're not moving in the right direction. This can be reckless behavior. This can be a show-off, you know, a one-hit wonder that is afraid of commitment. So, you know, I don't know if it is a show-off. It doesn't have to be, but it could be somebody that's very boastful and proud and, you know, doesn't want to settle or didn't. Let's change that doesn't to a didn't. Didn't want to settle down, didn't want to get committed. But there's options here. There's a choice. And there's consequences for that choice. So somebody is dealing with thinking about what their heart wants. Thinking about somebody that they have some sort of memories with, by the looks of things. There's unhappiness here. Some sort of unhappiness with this Four of Wands reversed. I feel like there's a relationship that is about to become more committed. You know, somebody, a deep soul connection or something like that. Real love is coming soon, something like that. Somebody, or somebody's going to be deepening a bond. Okay, if you're already in a connection, your bond is going to be deepening, or things are going to start to look up. Feels like there's some sort of... somebody is thinking about a connection, they're thinking about commitment, they're thinking about expressing their feelings, and they're probably afraid. They're probably afraid of, you know, marriage or something like that. I don't know if it's marriage. Somebody may also be getting out of a commitment. They may be getting out of a commitment because there's no passion there. There's no desire. There's no attraction, right? I mean, the Knight of Wands reverse, that's no desire. They may have a connection with somebody else, you know, that they have some memories with. Anyhow, choosing another option. Somebody is choosing another option. They've been thinking about it a lot, put it that way. Death on the bottom. This is an ending that leads to a new beginning. So this is exactly what this is. Somebody is ending something. They are ending something that they are not happy with so that they can have a new beginning. This is a new beginning. This is the death of a situation with a new beginning to follow. I feel like there's going to be some sort of reunion with a soulmate, okay? It's like a soulmate reunion that is coming up. And it's somebody's choice to do so. And when I say soulmate reunion, it could be somebody brand new that you met in a past life, okay? So don't get all bent out of shape for those of you that hate your ex. By the way, if you do hate your ex, you got some healing to do. A lot of it. Doesn't mean you have to get back together with them. Anyhow, reminiscing about the past. There even could be an apology here or an offer. Somebody may be getting an invite or an offer, or their relationship is stepping it up to a next level, or they're getting into an unexpected commitment. And it's because they just got out of one. You know, they were able to let go of one that didn't make them happy by the looks of things. Seven of Swords. Ooh, Seven of Swords, that is using reason, using logic, plotting and planning. Somebody is planning something. Somebody is planning something. They're planning, it's almost like they're planning their attack, right? Somebody is planning their attack right now. They are. And I don't think it's an attack in a bad way. I mean, to some it may, but... somebody is, it's a surprise. This is a surprise. You may have somebody that wasn't quite ready. They weren't quite ready to give up. You know, they weren't quite ready to give up their options, you know. We have a very cunning individual. It feels like this person is coming back, you know. Coming back in, whatever that means. See, it's headed towards that Six of Cups. Somebody may be spying as well. Well, we're going to take this pile. There's only three. Four of Swords. Now, this is sneaking away as well. So I wonder if somebody is sneaking away. Four of Swords, Ten of Cups, World reversed. Now, this is unfinished business. There's some sort of unfinished business. A lack of success. The end of a relationship. A relationship is ending. This is the death of a relationship. Somebody has exhausted, you know, they're exhausted, they're fed up, they just don't want to do it anymore. So the relationship is ending. There's probably some unfinished business, and now upright, this is leaving the past behind. With the past, somebody has some unfinished business with somebody from the past. That they may have been in a relationship or some sort of, I don't know, maybe it was a one-night stand. It could have been, because the Knight of Wands can be a one-night stand. I don't know, but... It could have been. So, Something's not over yet. With that World card reverse, it's just not over yet. Also, somebody could be leaving without saying goodbye. You know, we got thousands of people watching this. And we did have that Death card, which is an ending. That's a death. The death is an ending. And this is an ending. And this is an ending. And this is an ending. So we definitely have an ending here. Somebody is slipping away. They're sneaking away. They're leaving. And they could be leaving without saying goodbye. Or maybe that's what has happened. There's definitely some unfinished business here. But happiness is waiting if somebody can take action on their thoughts, because they obviously been thinking about it. It's clear that they have. They've been thinking about it a lot, especially at night when they're in bed. You know, they may have been praying for a reunion, or praying to go home or to go back or something. Praying for love or acceptance without, you know, it's like somebody's been praying. I feel like there's been some prayers here. But there's been some sort of deception. There's been some sort of deception. There's been some sort of illusion. Somebody's been playing games. They have. And maybe they just didn't, they were too flighty. You know, they weren't ready to settle down. Anyway, I do feel as though there's a new relationship that is about to be more committed. And if you are in a relationship and everything is going well, there could even be a proposal. There could be, because I mentioned marriage. But with this World card reversed, this is something is not over yet. It's not over. So something isn't over. There's somebody's, you know, chapter or whatever isn't completely over yet with a certain person. It's not over. And there is a new beginning here. There is. But this is the death of an idea or person. It is. There could be a sudden departure that leads to a sudden arrival as well. Somebody could be suddenly leaving, which enables or brings somebody suddenly in, okay? And that could resonate in whatever part of your life that, you know, could be work, could be home, could be job, could be relationship. I do see, you know, unexpected good news coming in for an individual that totally doesn't expect it. It's from somebody that may have been elusive, you know, or confused or unsure of what they wanted. But now this person or whatever has made up their mind. It feels like they've made up their mind and they're looking for happiness. You know, something may have happened in their life that has given them a new perspective. Interesting that I started this out with it doesn't matter. You know, it doesn't matter. It's not, it's, you know, something doesn't matter. You know, it doesn't, let's start over. And I don't know who that's for. I don't know who that's for. There is some sort of, that Page of Cups is an offer of love of some sort. Somebody's going to be showing their feelings, following their heart and their gut. There could be an admirer. This could even be a secret admirer. It absolutely could be a secret admirer. Okay. But it may be somebody that you already know. Because I feel like it is. If you are in a relationship now and everything is peachy, then your relationship may be stepping it up to the next level. You may be hearing news of a birth with that Page of Cups or a child, you know. There is a relationship that is going to come out of this, however it resonates with you. Somebody may have been praying for happily ever after. You know, thinking that it was never going to happen, you know, clinging to their past. I feel like there's a sudden arrival of some sort. Good luck.